next, what I want to do is I want to fix the login and register page as well. So if you see the login page, so currently login page, you see this text is cutting here when I'm going in the mobile mode. And when I go to the register page, text is good. However, input text boxes are very nicely aligned here. It is taking the entire area and it looks good. However, if I go to the login page, text are not taking the entire area and also it is cutting my text. So let's fix them. So we will start from the login component and fix it up. So let's fix the login component to make it responsive and register component to make it responsive. And next we'll just finish the product page as well. So if you go to the login page, login component, so you see here, all of my text boxes that we have, the mat form field, they do not have the full width. And therefore, they are basically just using the default area that is supplied to it. Even the entire table, we don't have a full width. So if you just compare with the register component here, real quick. So in register component, you see here in the table, we are applying the full width. And for each form field, we are applying the full width, which is basically missing in the login component. So that's the problem. So what I should do is I should just get the full width style from register. And it is nothing but just the width 100%. I copy this and put it into login, full width. Another thing you can notice it is the card that we have it here. It has 800, 150 and 10% auto. However, here it is different. That is why they are not matching. What I should just take the CSS part of this card and apply it here. Still, it is not working, right? Because this full width we have not applied into our form fields. So let's go ahead and apply that. So I go here. First in the mat, we say check login card is there. However, in the table, there is no full width. So I can just say class full width, this one. And then for the form also, we can copy this class full width from here and put it here. Similarly, for the next form, we'll do the same like this. And then that's it. This way, if I go to the login page, I should see the entire area it is covering, which is exactly like register page entire area it was covering. So that is one thing. Another thing you see now, it is wrapping, start wrapping the thing. So I don't like this kind of alignment. I don't want to completely do CSS, but just the small thing, we should fix it. So what we should do is we should take this login button to take the entire area. And then we'll make the other thing like the text part of it as a next div. So we'll create two div, and one div will take the login area and then another div where we'll put the entire text message. So let's try to do that. So I'll go ahead and remove this register page from here. So you see in this card action, let's start wrapping the div, the button inside the div. And then here, you may apply div, you may not, it's fine. Only thing we want to apply is here the class thing. So we can just say class as a full width. So where it acquires the entire area. Next thing what we want is this span that we have a text thing. So this one we can just put some margin on it. So if you see here, it is just sticked under the button. I can just apply some margin here and that will fix that problem. So I can say margin top on this one. Margin top to put some unit. And this will not apply if you just use the span. That is the problem. So therefore, you want to wrap them in the div. And then here you apply this margin thing, cut it, put it here. So this way it should just apply margin as well as you will see some gap here. And then login button is coming. Login button we are using properly. So we have a class full width, raise button and color. And then sometimes you want to just make it default. Like if you hit enter, it should just do login. Right now it is not doing. So how can you do that is just put some indexing on it. So by default, you can put the tab index thing that you can pass it as zero. So that way it just make this guy as a default button. So that way you see this. So if I hit tab and then hit enter, it goes. If I go to logout, login, and hit enter, so by default it will not take, but if you go to the tab, and then it is going. So this login page is looking good. The same thing, we want to fix it in the register page. If you go to the register page, it is looking good, but it is not consistent. So if I go to the register login page here, and then if you don't have an account, register here is fine. And then I can just, if you compare to our cloud application here, if I go and say log out and go to the login page, I just say new to Product Mart, then sign up. So this way you build your brand basically, instead of saying if you have no account and all of that. So let's put the Product Mart name here, and then basically we'll say sign up. Okay, this is good. So next let's go to the, so now you see proper message is coming. Okay, so next go to the register page and do the same thing quickly there. So let's put the button here and we'll say class, right? Class is equal to full width. Next thing we did is we wrapped this under the div and we gave some margin. And this one we can apply the style inline style, we can just say margin top as a 2 unit, and we should see the register page also properly. So this is the sign up page where it comes properly, and then you can always match the text if there is some different text we have. So what we have for sign up, already have an account, so if you go here, sign up, already have an account and login here, which is almost same. Okay, so now it is almost, it is going there, we are matching. Okay, this is our cloud application, this is our application, which is almost going there. There is something going on there. Okay, so login and register page looks good. Okay, so next what we should focus on is the products one. So if I go to products, see this one looks like this. And here if I go to the products, it looks like this. So let's fix this. So what I will use here in order to fix the products page, products component, is I will not use the card directly, because if you see the code, I'm using card in the products page. Mat card and mat grid and all of that, right? So I don't have control that much to make it responsive and all. So what I preferred is to make it as a table. This is a table. Okay, so let's see how do we fix that.